to the world today on CGTN, coming to you live from Beijing.
The lead story on Chinese state television. Beijing hits back at the British press. The news bulletin broadcasting comments from a foreign ministry spokesman objecting to what he calls biased coverage.
They have ideological prejudice towards China and fabricate news about China.
It comes after similar comments from the deputy head of the Chinese embassy here in Australia. In a speech to business leaders this week, he called out media outlets for their unfavourable coverage of Chinese Australians, saying it seems that being friendly to China to be a friend of China becomes a sin and a mistake in Australia. Tensions between the two countries have been simmering for some time, and a new study suggests there's been an increase in racism as a result.
The high-level politics really does impact daily lives and the safety of Chinese Australians.
Of the 1,000 Chinese Australians surveyed, 18% reported being physically threatened or attacked because of their heritage last year. Almost one-third say they were treated unfairly. 37% say they were called offensive names. Despite this, 77% say Australia is still a good place to live, and 63% feel they belong here.
We as a society need to really pressure those in positions of leadership to actually call out these attacks.
Popular Chinese Australian YouTuber Edgar Liu says he was shocked by the figures of abuse in the Lowy report.
I personally cannot relate to that number. According to my own experience, I've been here for 7 years, including the last year, so I've encountered 1.5 racial discriminating kind of thing.
He says that while he's been racially abused in the street, he generally feels accepted.
Things like that will make me stop and think, oh, maybe it's not, Australia's not as good as I thought. But after I stop and think, that I can attribute to you know, there are always jerks everywhere, no matter where you are.
The report suggests the COVID-19 pandemic, which was first detected in China, has also contributed to growing racism. Lucy Murray, SBS World News.